Hi guys, Toshi here from Mixing Tips, and today we are going to share with you a few pointers on how to set your gain staging, why is it important for your mix, and why we are doing this at the beginning, even before the mixing starts. The main and ultimate reason why we are doing this is to set the optimal level of our tracks, just to avoid any distortion happening if one of the tracks or the master channel starts clipping. The clipping and distortion happens after the signal goes over 0 decibels, and you should avoid this at any cost. Sometimes, if you set the volume on every channel properly and none of them are clipping, when they are summed up together, the master signal will be clipping, and that is an issue that you will need to fix. The simple solution for this is to have all the tracks in the range from minus 16 to minus 8 decibels, which will result in having the master channel not clipping and be at around minus 6 to minus 3 decibels. These are the numbers that you will need to aim for, and you should be good to move on with the mix. This should be enough of a headroom left for your mastering engineer, and they will be grateful if you do this part right. Every separate mastering guy might have different preferences on the headroom, so if you already picked your mastering guy, get in touch with them and try to double check what decibel level is at their liking. When you're working with audio tracks, the starting process for the gain staging should be with the faders. Adjust the faders up to your taste and always check the meter if you are at the right level. Once the mixing process starts and you begin with adding plugins to mix, compensate for the volume boosted inside the plugins with the output level knob that this same plugin already has. The reason to do this is just to maintain the same level of the gain stage as the input level you already have. This is a step often overlooked because many engineers think that if something gets louder, it sounds better. But in total opposition to that, you're just doing harm to your mix and you're messing with the initial gain stage that you already set. If you are creating track with a virtual instrument, every one of them has leveling meter in it, and you will be able to set the optimal level from here. At this point, you can make another mistake here. Here is the thing. If you lower the volume for your virtual instrument from the mixer fader, you might be going below 0 decibels, and you will be able to avoid clipping from this point. But if your instrument is clipping inside of the plugin, and if the meter inside the plugin goes over 0, practically here you will be just lowering distorted signal. Try not to do that, go back into your plugin and fix it from there, lower the volume from the plugin itself, and then from the mixer fader you will be able to make more precise fixes with the leveling. Another thing to mention here is to go ahead and try to have all your faders as close as possible to their initial level at 0 decibels or at the unity level. For the sake of knowing how loud every track in your song is. With this option, you will have total control over your mix, and you will be able to move on knowing that your gain staging is set properly. Okay, so these are our 2 cents on the gain staging. In the following part, we are going to show with volume how did we set the leveling for this instrumental. Thank you for tuning in again today. Subscribe to our channel, share the good word of mixing, and spread the word around. Thank you very much once again, and see you in the next video.